Esta semana es todo acerca de una de las voces que se ganó nuestra atención en el año 2008, bajo el label Adjusted Music, junto a The Thrill Seekers. Y me refiero al inolvidable The Last Time. Pero su trayectoria no solo se remonta a este trabajo en particular, sino también incluye releases con Bass Vision, Moussa Clark, Sean Tyas y Paul Van Dyke. Además, sus éxitos no solo se limitan a la escena trance. Su voz también la podemos encontrar en TV shows y películas. Su nombre real es Kathleen Fisher, quien nos va a contar algunos secretos detrás de éxitos como Save Me y The Last Time. Ella es Fisher.
Hi, it's Fisher. Hello to all of you out there tonight listening to Friday Nights Worldwide with Eric Gucci. It's really great to be here. I'm just outside the Los Angeles area. The Last Time was one of my favorite tracks ever. It ranks right up there with True Love, which we did with George Acosta. But The Last Time with the Thrill Seekers was a song that was really, really, really from the heart. And I think that's what can make a song live longer than others. I'm glad you like Save Me. It was kind of a interesting experience. I was working on two songs with Leon at once. And some of the ideas merged into the other ideas, but we actually only work through the internet because I live in California and he's in Europe. So we would just literally ping pong back and forth. What do you think of this? What do you think of that? What do you think of this? And Leon's great because he's very open, and I think we have a really mutual respect for one another. So there's never that uncomfortable feeling of, oh, I hate to tell you this, but, you know, can we change that? It's always like, yeah, let's try it. I actually had my first release with Leon back about 7 years ago, I think, was a song called By Your Side, which we released through Black Hole. So we actually go back a ways, and it's been a really fulfilling relationship. I think all music is constantly evolving like fashion. You know, like it's cyclical, and some things repeat themselves, and then every now and then something will seem really fresh. I think for myself personally, I tend to have a lot of weather in my lyrics, rain and storms and seas, and I think it's because EDM is so emotional, and I think Mother Nature just kind of captures that. But just from what I've been listening to lately, I feel like the lyrics have gotten more interesting. I think we're coming into a time of more original ideas. And I'm always happy to hear more male singers. I think sometimes it feels like we're inundated with the female voice. And that's kind of, why am I saying that? I'm a female singer. But in pop music, there have been these trends where it's all male voices, and very few female. And we've had this great resurgence of female voices into pop music, but I almost feel like the EDM world was getting a little too heavy on the female side. And I think we were all starting to sound alike. So I'm actually really happy to hear more male voices come in. And I see a lot more pop structure coming into EDM, which is what I've always strived to do whenever I work on a song, is have the creativity, have the vibe, have the sensuality, but not lose the structure so that you know where you are. You're floating within it, but you know where you are. I have some great projects coming up. I have two songs with Karanda that we're going to release with Rasmussen, and I have a new one coming out with Simon Bostock. So get ready for the summer. Fisher's coming. I'm back. I'm ready for action. You can reach out to me at Twitter at FisherEDM. Or just know that we're in touch through the music, and go do something cool. Get off the internet and go do something cool. Did I just say cool? Twice. I did.
Gracias por revelar algunos de los secretos detrás de singles esenciales en nuestro programa. Lo que sigue es el Tune of the Week. George Acosta y Fisher. True Love.
This is The Tune of the Week.
No.